Hi Gemini, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and to your first love read, the in-depth love read for the month. Ooh, the Emperor just slipped out of the deck before I even started to shuffle the cards. So I'll keep this Emperor here. Let's see, maybe he has to say something to say here. And as I was saying, let's start your reading. And these are general collective readings, Gemini. Will not resonate with all of you. Please take what works for you and leave the rest. So let's see what action we can expect in this connection, how you're feeling and how your person is feeling. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Gemini and send them the messages they need to hear the most about their love life now. Thank you. All right, Gems, let's start. Welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you. Thank you for being here. And Gemini, if you're new here, we welcome you as well. Do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. We welcome you in. Ooh, Six of Cups and the Wheel of Fortune. Five of Cups, Nine of Swords, the Moon, and the Four of Wands. Beautiful. For person B. Okay, for me, this is going to be person A, Gems. This is going to be person B. If this is your storyline, you'll know immediately which side you resonate best with, right? So, for person B, the World card, the King of Cups, Seven of Pentacles, Ten of Cups, the Queen of Cups, and the Tower in reverse. Action for person A and action for person B. Bottom of my deck, I have the Empress in reverse. So that is a feminine energy. You see, I have the Emperor and the Empress now together. The Emperor slipped out before, and Empress is by overall energy. So this is an equal match. But something could have happened here, maybe in the past, that the Empress is kind of not sure whether they want to move forward or have any kind of growth with this Emperor now. Let's see why that is. I have a feeling this Emperor was a bit selfish and self-centered in the past, and that kind of turned this Empress off. So let me look at the cards. From what I feel here, Gemini, one person wants to come back. They want to come back. They want things to move, start moving smoothly in a forward direction once again. But the other person, they kind of are on the verge of maybe shutting this chapter down. Why? They did. I mean, according to what I see, they do have a lot of love for person A. But they feel my person has never really opened up to me, never revealed any emotions. They always blow hot and cold, and I feel they've been emotionally manipulating me till now. So maybe it's time for me to shut this chapter down. So what's going to happen later, we'll do later. First, let's start with our dialogue message cards here, Gemini. Let's see if you guys could say something to each other, what that would be, and then we'll go on with the rest of the story. So Gemini and their person, spirit, if they could say something to each other now, what would that be? Gemini and their person. Gemini and their person. Gemini and their person. All right. I'm going to take a few more Gemini from another deck. And if any of you are looking for personal readings, my email is in the description box below. You can reach me there. Gemini and their person. Okay, good to go. Let's start your reading, Gemini. The first card here says, do you really believe I'm the one for you? You made me realize I had flaws. I'm trying to do better now. Missing you so much. We truly did have something special. I'm happy for you. I want to reach out, but I'm scared of what you might say. See, somebody wants to come back now, but may have messed up in the past. Trying to gather up the courage to get in contact with you. See? Wishing you the best, even if it's with someone else. That could be this Empress saying that, who's thinking of shutting this chapter down. Wishing you the best, even if it's with someone else. I did not expect you to enter my life when you did. I wasn't ready. Are you sorry for hurting me? And the last card here, Gemini, says, I'm learning that I can still have a great life without you. This is this Empress again. Alright, so Gems, if these cards were resonating with your storyline, let's start your reading. I'm going to start with an angel blessing card as always. Let's see what my angels have for you first. My angels, blessing, guidance, advice, or a message for Gemini, please. Blessing, wise decision. Somebody now wants to make the right decision here, Gemini. I think this is the Emperor who is now wanting to do the right thing. Okay. So, Six of Cups for person A. I'll forget about person B, okay? I'm going to just concentrate on person A first. Let's see what they're going through. Then we'll go on to the other side. So, person A, why do you feel this way? Six of Cups and the Wheel of Fortune, both upright. They are very sorry about what happened. They're very guilty, very sorry. Maybe they were meant to make a choice or a decision in love or lovers, I don't know, but they didn't make it on time, which they are extremely sorry for. This person has a lot of sadness, a lot of regret. I have this card twice for them, not even once. They're really, really sorry about whatever happened. Maybe, you know, they didn't choose the Empress on time, or I don't know, something happened here which they have a lot of regret for. They do want to come back because they're realizing, I still have a lot of attraction for person B. This is my divine counterpart. We were meant to be. This was a gift from the universe to me. And now they want to put in the work. Yes, they want to put in the work. They want to offer, can we have a brand new start, please? I still have a lot of passion for you. I'm willing to put in the work now. I'm sorry about the past, that I never did the right thing, I never made that choice. So the Wheel of Fortune, Spirit, why do they feel this way? Wheel of Fortune, what do they expect? They want their Empress back. They want this Empress back in the upright now. They're not happy with this Empress upside down and saying, you know, let's let it be. I don't want to have anything to do with you anymore. Person A really wants their luck to change for this Empress now to match them, and they are willing to be their Emperor, and I want my Empress back. Beautiful. So what happened in the recent past, Person A, that you're feeling this way? Five of Cups, again, they're haunted by their past actions, I guess. They did feel that soulmate connection. They did feel that soulmate connection. They did know that they had to do the right thing, but maybe they didn't. Maybe they didn't. They always knew that there was a very special bond with person B. And they knew that, you know, that there was a potential for everything good with person B, but they never made that choice, which led to a lot of maybe overthinking, stressing, sleepless nights, Nine of Swords. What's the Nine of Swords? Off. Okay, Emperor again. How many times have I got that Emperor and Empress card? It's unbelievable. Yes, they knew they had to do the right thing and be that Emperor for this Empress in the past. But I guess they couldn't make up their mind in the past. So I have the Emperor out twice already, Gemini. I have the Empress out twice already. So person A in the past, I think they felt it in their gut that person B was the right choice, but they took too long, or they were juggling, or they were overthinking this connection too much. So how do they feel now, Spirit? How do they feel about person B or this connection overall? What are the feelings now? The Moon in reverse. They want to come back so bad, Gemini. They want to just bear everything that they've hidden away for so long. They want to be absolutely truthful, honest. No more secrets. What they really have in mind is the Four of Wands now. They want that happily ever after. Four of Wands, Spirit? Why is that on their mind? regarding this connection. Four of Wands. They want to come and speak the truth now. They want to speak their truth about maybe in the past they were more inclined towards being single and focusing on their work or something, or just being abundant and happy on their own, and that's the reason they didn't make that decision. But now they are recognizing the value of having an empress in their life, and they want this partnership so that you guys can be together. Am I right, spirit? What else? How else do they feel? They want to tell person B that you make all my wishes come true. You are my wish fulfillment. I recognize that now, and I want to do the right thing. So yes, no wonder the emperor came out right in the beginning. Somebody is ready now, absolutely ready to woo their empress back. So what action they'll take, this is all in their mind space. So what action, physical action they'll take, I will open later. Gemini, let's go on to the other side and see what's happening with person B. Person B has the World card. Why is that, person B? Might you feel this way? Person B feels that this connection was just not working out. My person was always busy doing other things, maybe third parties. Now third parties could be, the third party could have been their work or not putting in work in this connection. And they feel that person was very rash and immature and just swept in and swept out, never stayed for long. They left as fast as they came. And it's better to shut this chapter down than be feeling that I'm always being emotionally manipulated. Person B says, I do know they love me. I do know that they have love for me, but they were always doing this sneaky stuff. They would come and then they would run. They would come and then they would run. And that kind of really bothered me. King of Cups, why do they feel this way, spirit? Yeah, I think person B is kind of, may have asked or may have demanded to know the truth about this King of Cups feelings. And maybe this King of Cups was emotionally closed off and they ran. So person B says, hey, I've got my boundaries up now. I'm still open to having that communication, but I'm a little wary now. I'm going to keep my guard up. So what happened in the recent past on your perspective? What happened to you that you feel this way, person B? Seven of Cups. Person B says, well, we had a potential of the Ten of Cups. I felt it. I know they felt it. But there was so much confusion in this connection because nobody really spoke about their emotions. I mean, they didn't, so I didn't. I didn't, so they didn't. My person was always emotionally closed off, and that confused me. I felt that maybe they had other options, and that's the reason they were not speaking the truth. And slow and steady, I think this connection just came to a halt. I was holding back, and then they were holding back, and then they were holding back, and I was holding back. It just led to so much confusion in this connection. And things started going a different direction, a wrong direction, because neither of us would really, you know, open up. Ten of Cups. What happened in the recent past with the Ten of Cups? This person B feels that, at least from their end, they were not confused. I mean, they had made that decision. They knew that person A was the right direction. This was like a gift from the universe where we were supposed to be happily ever after or have emotional satisfaction and go the long haul. But then it came to an end because of all this confusion, because of this holding back and not expressing or going silent on each other. My person was always so closed off that, well, I have decided it's over. So, person A, how do you see this connection now? Person B. How does person B now see this connection with person A? Person B is telling me, sitting here as the Queen of Cups, I still do have a lot of love for them. I do admire them. I do love them. And yes, I'm willing to put my barriers down if they can come to me correct, if they can offer me equal give and take. That's all I always wanted, that we have a partnership. You give me, I give you, you're my empress, I'm your emperor, I'm your empress, whatever. And let's not keep these, you know, blockages or barriers between us. Otherwise, underneath it all, I think I do, still do love them. Tower in reverse. Tower in reverse. Tower in reverse. But somewhere person B feels it's too late. But, I mean, everything has already crashed now. They're not sure that a second chance is even possible. But they are still emotional about person A. They feel sad at a missed opportunity. They feel sad that this new beginning, you know, never really took off. Anything else? Yeah, because this was such a beautiful partnership, right? This was like a gift from the universe. I keep saying that. This was such a beautiful soulmate connection, had so much potential. But I think person B is wondering whether a second chance was even possible. Whether we can rebuild this connection. So let's see what's going to happen. If person A takes some correct action and person B, things can work out. Because I don't see anything very wrong here except person B is kind of lost hope. So I'm going to take a different deck for this one and see what's happening. And of course, this is my cue this time to tell you I know you guys are here, so you're hearing me. If it's resonating even a little bit, just a little thumbs up click would really make me feel good and also help these videos to circulate. Thank you so much. And newbies, if you are here and going to subscribe, don't forget to press that notification bell so you don't miss out any of the future videos. So let's see. Person A, the action they intend to take, Queen of Swords in reverse. Why is that? Why is that in action? I think they're scared of person B. Yes, oh my God, Five of Swords, Five of Wands, and the Eight of Swords. Person B is so afraid. They're totally in their head. Gemini, whoever person A is, if it's you, so many swords, right? They feel that person B doesn't trust them at all. They will never give them a second chance, and if they do go forward with any kind of offer, they will cut their head off. So I think person A is sitting in this worry that it may end up in another fight. I don't know what to say. I put them in competition in the past. Now, what if they don't believe me? They will never trust me. What should I do? So does that mean, person A, you won't take any action? Just sit and worry? You just sit and worry? Any action from your end? Yes, they are very scared. Very, very, very afraid that deep in their emotions, they can't see the light. They're drowning in their emotions of their worry as to how to now come back and say, I am the emperor to the empress or vice versa. What is the action you'd like to take? Forget about your worry, person A. If you just could, what is the action you would like to take? What's the action that you would like to take towards person B? In the perfect world. Well, they say person B feels that I know I've really messed up in the past. I was not sure of my... I was giving them mixed signals in the past, but now I want to make things right. I really want to find balance and harmony once again. I want to now move towards them steady and stable. Not the rash in and out kind of behavior which I was doing. I want to plant those seeds and I want to watch them grow from scratch. I want a brand new beginning. And even if it starts small, I'm willing to work for it. Step by step by step, I want to bring this connection back into harmony. So they're wondering how to do that. Person B, any action from your end towards person A or otherwise? Any action from your end? The Lovers in reverse. Gems, that's again your card. Why is the lovers in reverse in action? Is that a choice you're making? Some wise decision for yourself? Or this connection? One more. Ooh. Person B does have a lot of love. Person B is waiting for that love offer. They're waiting for that love offer. They are wishing upon a star and hoping for divine guidance. I don't think person B is going to make any decision or movement, but because they're still holding back because of past hurt. But they're also holding on to this connection and maybe hope that one day I will be made that offer, or because they know the love is there. So they're waiting for the universe to guide them. One more. So you're just going to sit and wish and hope, or will you take any action, person B? The world. Yes, they are open both ways. They are open both ways. They feel whatever I'm guided to do is what will be. Either I'll have to shut this chapter down and start a brand new with or without this person A, but I'm going to go with the flow, because I think person B is into self-love more than anything else. They've discovered themselves. Yeah, all they want is to be away and out of any scenario which is going to be cheating, sneaky, any lies. So I don't think person B is making any choice, because they don't want to go back into this place of again being stressed out. Nine of Swords. I can't take any more sleepless nights. I'm healing from this past hurt. I'm loving myself. Actually, person B is almost on the verge of thinking that it's better that I shut this chapter down, because it gave me too much anxiety, too much of stress. But still trusting in the divine plan. Maybe if person A does come towards them, I do see a lot of love from the other person's side, which they're suppressing and trying to walk away from. So make some wise decisions, person A. Don't be in your head. Go and tell person B and win them back. That's what I would suggest. So we'll see next time. Love and light. Take care. Namaste.